Thank you. Be glad you have problems. Yes, that's right. Be thankful for every single problem you have. Problems are proof positive that you are alive and vital. The person with 10 problems is twice as alive as the person with only 5. A little while ago, I met an old friend of mine walking down New York's Fifth Avenue. His name was George. I've never before seen such a woebegone, hangdog look on old George. Well, I made the mistake of asking George how he was. Never was anyone so promptly, so fully informed as to the wickedness, the unhappiness, the compounded sorrow of another man's world. After hearing his tale of despair and disappointment for minutes on end, I resolved to be more careful about inquiring about George's health the next time. Finally, I said to him, "George, I'd like to be of some help to you. I'm certainly on your team and will do anything I can for you." "If you could only get me loose from this mess of problems," he said. "They're making my life miserable. Problems, problems, and more problems. That's all I have, and I'm sick of it." I was able to place a simple thought in his mind, a thought which gave him a new lease on success and happiness. I'll tell you what it was after this pause. I didn't solve all of George's problems then and there, but I did give him a thought which gave him a new lease on success and happiness. I said, "George, I was at a place the other day, not very far from here, where there are 100,000 people, and not a single one of them has a problem." Well, George thought I was pointing the way to a new utopia, and in a sense I was. He became enthusiastic and said, "That sure is for me. Where is this place?" Woodlawn Cemetery in the Bronx was the place I had in mind. "There are no problems there." "Not at all," I told George. "But the trouble is that everyone in Woodlawn is dead. So, George, don't be too worried that you have those problems, for actually they are signs of life. In order to handle your problems creatively, all you have to do is to follow this procedure. View the facts for what they are. Look at them realistically. But also look at them as a challenge to your intelligence, your ingenuity, and your confidence. Know that there is an answer, and that you'll find it. Attitude is more important than the facts themselves. Practice the art of hopefulness until you have it down pat, until it comes naturally. That way, you'll never have to take a final licking at any time, ever."